I'm Sanjaya Mishra, Education Specialist e-learning at the Commonwealth of Learning. This research was carried out at the CALLS Regional Center at New Delhi, the Commonwealth Educational Media Center for Asia, where I served as director previously. The research was largely exploratory in nature, that we wanted to understand the attitudes, motivation, barriers, and perception of quality of OER amongst Indian higher education teachers. The background to this research was based on our understanding of some teachers sharing their work and some not. So we were trying to understand that what is the scenario where most teachers are trying to share their educational materials with an open license or not. So can we create something, better understand something which will help more adoption of open educational resources in the Indian context? Our methodology was a mixed approach of qualitative and quantitative in nature. We had surveys, we had questionnaire based survey, we had we used a scale called Attitude Towards Open Educational Resources. We had interviews based on a set of questions which were grounded on Engstrom's activity theory approach. We did workshops in four educational universities to orient the participants about OER, and it was a kind of an extended focus group approach, and we also did interviews with some of the participants in this workshop. So a variety of data sources were used, including a group of teachers who were active in a OER platform which was Wiki Educator India. So it was a mix of different approaches taken into one to collect data from different sources and interpret. We have several interesting findings, and one of the most important fact is that teachers are once they know about OER and its potentiality, they are all positive about using it. So their attitudes are more predisposed towards the positive side. They are also motivated to use OER, and the motivation comes from both altruistic, or we can say intrinsic and extrinsic motivation, that they think that sharing is a teaching behavior and it's a good thing to do, and it's good for developing country, or it's low cost, so it's important thing to do to reduce the cost of learning. So those are the things. And at the same time, they're also looking at some recognition, some collaborative opportunities, which are external external factors that decide their use of OER in their teaching and learning. We also see that there are a lot of quality issues in OER, and teachers believe that they will use OER when the OERs are actually relevant and appropriate to their teaching learning context, or they are from trustworthy sources or reputed sources. So those are the issues on quality that we found. They also see that the perception of quality is that because some of the OERs are not peer reviewed, that is of questionable quality. That talks of that situation where we should talk about do OER. When we develop OER, we should make it peer reviewed as one of these outcomes. We also found that there are a lot of barriers, and two of the most important barriers that came on top are the lack of awareness about OER. So they would like to be engaged, but most teachers in higher education institutions don't know about OER. So that's number one. And the second thing is all about their lack of time to do. So workload is so high amongst teachers in Indian higher education institutions that they consider that doing OER work might be additional workload for them. Of course, some of these are not directly related, and some of the things if are related to the perception of additional work. Once OER is mainstream and it becomes part of the research and teaching learning of the teachers, I think some of these barriers will get down and become low in priority areas. But overall, this our research gives us a framework or a model that tells that what are the things that Indian higher education institutions should be doing in terms of mainstreaming OER, for example, having institutional policy, providing appropriate recognition, creating an able environment for training teachers, capacity building of teachers and making them aware, developing a mechanism for quality assurance of OER within the institutions, and so on and so forth. So our research brings out a model which should be adopted in Indian higher education institution to mainstream open educational resources. One of the important thing as a result of this research that I'd like to highlight in India currently happening is a lot of awareness, increased awareness about OER, because we did workshop in different places, the research created some buzz about OER. So that's happened, and also it's made some interest in the official circles in the ministries, among senior leaders, vice chancellors. So number of OER policies in institutions are coming up, and Government of India is also interested in developing a kind of OER policy for higher education. Commonwealth Learning's Regional Center, SEMCA, which is Commonwealth Educational Media Center for Asia, is assisting the Government of India to develop an OER policy for higher education currently. And we hope that a draft OER policy will be ready by the end of March 2017. So this is something we can talk about as an impact of the research work that we did at SEMCA, New Delhi.